I was getting a little bit bored actually walking. The problem is with walking is you can't really go very far. You're a little bit limited as to where you can go. So I decided to dust down my bike, get on my bike today and go looking for snowdrops because it's snowdrop season. Come with me, come and join with me. Bit of an adventure today. And it's a long, long time since I've been on my bike. I never knew that full moon bike riding was a thing, but the snow moon, the second full moon of 2021, made for an illuminating sight in the early morning sky. The name Snow Moon derives from the Native American tribes and was given because February is the month for snowfall and cold temperatures. You know, without a doubt, nature packs a few surprises. Like this morning, just out of the mist in front of me here, there's a group of hares, March hares, and they're jumping and springing about and having fun playing together. There's about 8 or 9 of them. It's absolutely fantastic to experience. They know I'm here, but they're not that bothered. They're just carrying on in the field, and it's just great to experience, to stop and watch and take some time out and enjoy. It will soon be the boxing time with the hares, so they'll be boxing and competing for mates. That will certainly be something to see. It was brilliant watching those hares, but the sun was coming up rapidly and it was time to put pedal to the metal. Weaving my way into the Nene Valley, the River Nene was a marvellous view to any visitor. When you're up early and you witness sunrises like this, is there any other place you'd rather be? I don't think so. I'm out of breath. I am so unfit. I hope we can find some beautiful snowdrops. They're hidden in the woods along this trail. So yeah, let's see what we can find. By this point, I was about 10 miles in and my knees were already starting to hurt. Whose idea was this to go biking? A little bit of exercise didn't harm anyone. That's what I said anyway before I set out. Oh well, now for this hill to conquer. Come on, Neil, you can do it. You're almost there. Put your back into it. You've almost made it. Who said Northamptonshire was a flat county? Well, all that effort was worth it to get views like this. It was great to see the river again, so I put down my bike and went for a little walk. Seeing the beautiful River Nene in her state of calm, I have such a yearning and a longing to spend time on her shores. There is a word in Portuguese that describes the feeling of longing better than any word in the English language. That word is saudade. There is no direct translation. It is a feeling of longing that is so intense and so great that it consumes my being. It is the feeling that brings me back to the river. It is the feeling that is overwhelming me as I see this beautiful river and I'm longing for lockdown to end so I can go back on the boat. Belonging and longing, I belong on a wild river, on a boat.
After 12 and a half miles, fantastic bike ride, I have finally made it to my location. It's glorious, absolutely gorgeous. I've had to park my bike up because the last 200 meters or so towards the woods, you go through a graveyard, and I think out of respect, it's good just to park up my bike and walk the rest of the way. Absolutely beautiful. Now, I was told by this wood actually by some friends on Facebook. So thank you very much. It's the last stretch. The trouble is, I've got to ride all the way back again. This graveyard is very old. Graveyards don't freak me out, actually. I know some people, they don't like walking through them, but I don't find them very scary. Oh wow. Oh wow. I could see the snowdrops. Goodness me. Wow, wow, wow. It's magical. This is what it's all about this time of year. A carpet of snowdrops. It's absolutely magical. Got the winter lights by the river. Wow, absolutely wow. I really wanted to show you this today.
The days are getting warmer, longer and brighter, and the walks are becoming more and more colourful as the flowers appear. For welcome assurance that the brighter days of spring are on their way, look no further than snowdrops. It has been a bumpy year for snowdrops, which are the first flowers to appear at the end of winter. The snowdrop may appear delicate, but it is a very hardy little plant, surviving snowfall and colder temperatures. It has long been associated with the winter. Its Latin classification, Galanthus nivalis, literally means milk flower of the snow. Thank you.
British folklore, snowdrops have come to symbolise hope and purity. There's a superstition that hangs around snowdrops. A single flower indicates impending death, and it should never be brought into the house. This is possibly as a result of the poisonous qualities it possesses.
Amazing. This is the wonder of nature. Absolutely beautiful. A whole carpet full of snowdrops. Snowdrops represent hope, and we certainly could do with a little bit of hope at the moment. Just coming to places like this, certainly very, very calming and very peaceful. This is definitely my kind of place. Listen to the sound of nature. Beautiful. If you're ever stressed or worried, just get yourself into nature and be mindful. Open your ears and open your eyes to the sights and the sounds. In times of stress, it certainly helps me.
You can use mist to your advantage, and it declutters the background in this shot and simplifies the picture with the carpet of snowdrops. Beautiful. More often than not, when I visit these beautiful places, I forget to take a picture of myself. So I decided on a self-portrait, just sitting quietly amongst the snowdrops. It was time to finally head back to the bike, but I must confess, I was feeling a little bit saddle sore. It was such a beautiful day down at the river. I was enjoying watching the light of the sun shimmering off of the water and the beautiful mist just rising slowly into the cold air. Birds were busy building a nest in the nearby tree, and it's the perfect place to let your worries float away and find inner peace. Relax to the nature sounds and have a fantastic day. There is literally miles and miles of beautiful riverside scenery to see and enjoy.
Amazing. I had to show you this. Absolutely amazing. Get out there with your camera. Get some pictures.
With the camera packed away back in my bag, it was a race against time to head home before the sun started setting, especially on these early winter nights.
Thank you. I've had a fantastic day seeking out the snowdrops, and we managed to find them, and they were beautiful, absolutely beautiful. So just to end the day, a gorgeous sunset, and then the long ride home. About 12 miles, and I could murder a cup of tea. You've enjoyed this episode, and I hope you've enjoyed my bike ride. My legs are certainly feeling it, but wow, what a reward. These snowdrops, absolutely stunning. If you've enjoyed this episode and you haven't already done so, please don't forget to subscribe. Every subscription does help my channel, and it doesn't cost a penny either. So if you haven't subscribed, why not? Don't forget to give me a thumbs up and also put a comment in the comments. Until next time, take care, stay safe everybody. Hopefully next time we might have a bit of boating, who knows. Take care, see you again soon. Bye.